Listen to the story told by the reed of being separated. Since I was cut from the reed bed, I have made this crying sound. Anyone apart from someone he loves understands what I say. Anyone pulled from a source longs to go back. At any gathering, I am there, mingling in the laughing and grieving. A friend to each, but few will hear the secrets hidden within the notes. No ears for that. Body flowing out of spirit.
Spirit
up from body. No concealing that mixing. But it's not given us to see the soul. The reed flute is fire, not wind. Be that empty. Hear the love fire tangled in the reed notes, as bewilderment melts into wine. The reed is a friend to all who want the fabric torn and drawn away. The reed is hurt and salve combining, intimacy and longing for intimacy. One song, a disastrous surrender and a fine love together. The one who secretly hears this is senseless. A tongue has one customer, the ear. A sugarcane flute has such effect because it was able to make sugar in the reed bed. The sound it makes is for everyone. Days full of wanting. Let them go by without worrying that they do. Stay where you are inside such a pure hollow note. Every thirst gets satisfied except that of these fish, the mystics who swim a vast ocean of grace, still somehow longing for it. No one lives in that without being nourished every day, but if someone doesn't want to hear the song of the reed flute, it is best to cut conversation short, say goodbye, and leave. When I see your face, the stones start spinning. You appear, all studying wanders. I lose my place. Water turns pearly. Fire dies down and doesn't destroy. In your presence, I don't want what I thought I wanted. Those three little hanging lamps. Inside your face, the ancient manuscripts seem like rusty mirrors. You breathe. New shapes appear. And the music of a desire as widespread as spring begins to move like a great wagon. Drive slowly, some of us walking alongside are lame. Today, like every other day, we wake up empty and frightened. Don't open the door to the study and begin reading. Take down a musical instrument. Let the beauty we love be what we do. There are hundreds of ways to kneel and kiss the ground. Out beyond ideas of wrongdoing and rightdoing, there is a field. I'll meet you there. When the soul lies down in that grass, the world is too full to talk about. Ideas, language, even the phrase, each other, doesn't make any sense. The breeze at dawn has secrets to tell you. Don't go back to sleep. You must ask for what you really want. Don't go back to sleep. People are going back and forth across the door sill where the two worlds touch. The door is round and open. Don't go back to sleep. I would love to kiss you. The price of kissing is your life. Now my loving is running toward my life, shouting, "What a bargain! Let's buy it!" Daylight, full of small dancing particles. In the one great turning, our souls are dancing with you. Without feet, they dance. Can you see them when I whisper in your ear? They try to say what you are, spiritual or sexual. They wonder about Solomon and all his wives. In the body of the world, they say, there is a soul, and you are that. But we have ways within each other that will never be said by anyone. Come to the orchard in spring. There is light and wine and sweethearts in the pomegranate flowers. If you do not come, these do not matter. If you do come, these do not matter. I don't get tired of you. Don't grow weary of being compassionate toward me. All this thirst equipment must surely be tired of me. The water jar, the water carrier. I have a thirsty fish in me that can never find enough of what it's thirsty for. Show me the way to the ocean. Break these half measures, these small containers, all this fantasy and grief. Let my house be drowned in the wave that rose last night out of the courtyard hidden in the center of my chest. Joseph fell like the moon into my well. The harvest I expected was washed away, but no matter, a fire has risen above my tombstone. I don't want learning, or dignity, or respectability. I want this music, and this dawn, and the warmth of your cheek against mine. The grief armies assemble, but I'm not going with them. This is how it always is when I finish a poem. A great silence overcomes me, and I wonder why I ever thought to use language. Last year, I admired wines. This, I'm wandering inside the red world. Last year, I gazed at the fire. This year, I am burnt kebab. Thirst drove me down to the water, where I drank the moon's reflection. Now I am a lion, staring up totally lost. With the thing itself. Don't ask questions about longing. Look in my face. Soul drunk, body ruined. These two sit helpless in a wrecked wagon. Neither knows how to fix it. And my heart, I'd say it was more like a donkey, sunk in a mud hole, struggling and miring deeper. But listen to me for one moment. Quit being sad. hear blessings dropping their blossoms around you. God. Consider the difference in our actions and God's actions. We often ask, "Why did you do that?" Or, "Why did I act like that?" We do act, and yet everything we do is God's creative action. We look back and analyze the events of our lives, but there is another way of seeing. A backward and forward at once vision that is not rationally understandable. Only God can understand it. Satan made the excuse, "You caused me to fall." Whereas Adam said to God, "We did this to ourselves." After this repentance, God asked Adam, "Since all is within my foreknowledge, why didn't you defend yourself with that reason?" Adam answered, "I was afraid, and I wanted to be reverent. Whoever acts with respect will get respect. Whoever brings sweetness will be served almond cake. Good women are drawn to be with good men. Honor your friend, or treat him rudely, and see what happens. Love, tell an incident now that will clarify this mystery of how we act freely and are yet compelled. One hand shakes with palsy, another shakes because you slapped it away. Both tremblings come from God, but you feel guilty for the one, and what about the other?" These are intellectual questions. The spirit approaches the matter differently. Omar once had a friend, a scientist, Bulhakam, who was flawless at solving empirical problems. But he could not follow Omar into the area of illumination and wonder. Now, I return to the text, and he is with you wherever you are. But when have I ever left it? Ignorance is God's prison. Knowing is God's palace. We sleep in God's unconsciousness. We wake in God's open hand. We weep God's rain. We laugh God's lightning. Fighting and peacefulness both take place within God. Who are we then in this complicated world tangle? That is really just the single straight line down at the beginning of Allah. Nothing. We are emptiness. When you are with everyone but me, you are with no one. When you are with no one but me, you are with everyone. Instead of being so bound up with everyone, be everyone. When you become that many, you are nothing. Empty. How does a part of the world leave the world? How can wetness leave water? Don't try to put out a fire by throwing on more fire. Don't wash a wound with blood. No matter how fast you run, your shadow more than keeps up. Sometimes it's in front. Only full overhead sun diminishes your shadow. But that shadow has been serving you. What hurts you blesses you. Darkness is your candle. Your boundaries are your quest. I can explain this, but it would break the glass cover on your heart, and there's no fixing that. You must have shadow and light source both. Listen and lay your head under the tree of awe. When from that tree, feathers and wings sprout on you, be quieter than a dove. Don't open your mouth for even a coo. When a frog slips into the water, the snake cannot get it. And the frog climbs back out and croaks, and the snake moves toward him again. Even if the frog learned to hiss, still the snake would hear through the hiss the information he needed, the frog voice underneath. But if the frog could be completely silent, then the snake would go back to sleeping. And the frog could reach the barley. The soul lives there in the silent breath. And that grain of barley is such that when you put it in the ground, it grows. Are these enough words? Or shall I squeeze more juice from this? Who am I, my friend? You are granite. I am an empty wine glass. You know what happens when we touch. You laugh, like the sun coming up laughs at a star that disappears into it. Love opens my chest, and thought returns to its confines. Patience and rational considerations leave. Only passion stays, whimpering and feverish. Some men fall down in the road like dregs thrown out. Then, totally reckless, the next morning they gallop out with new purposes. Love is the reality, and poetry is the drum that calls us to that. Don't keep complaining about loneliness. Let the fear language of that theme crack open and float away. Let the priest come down from his tower and not go back up. The wakened lover speaks directly to the beloved. You're the sky my spirit circles in, the love inside love, the resurrection place. Let this window be your ear. I have lost consciousness many times with longing for your listening silence and your life-quickening smile. You give attention to the smallest matters, my suspicious doubts, and to the greatest. You know my coins are counterfeit, but you accept them anyway, my impotence and my pretending. I have 5 things to say, 5 fingers to give into your grace, First, when I was apart from you, this world did not exist, nor any other. Second, whatever I was looking for was always you. Third, why did I ever learn to count to three? Fourth, my cornfield is burning. Fifth, this finger stands for Rabia, and this is for someone else. Is there a difference? Are these words or tears? Is weeping speech? What shall I do, my love? So he speaks, and everyone around begins to cry with him, laughing crazily, moaning in the spreading union of a lover and beloved. This is the true religion. All others are thrown away bandages beside it. This is the sema of slavery and mastery dancing together. This is not being. Neither words nor any natural fact can express this. I know these dancers. Day and night I sing their song. This phenomenal cage. My soul, don't try to answer now. Find a friend and hide. But what can stay hidden? Love's secret is always lifting its head out from under the covers. Here I am. I used to want buyers for my words. Now I wish someone would buy me away from words. I've made a lot of charmingly profound images. Scenes with Abraham and Abraham's father, Azar, who was also famous for icons. I'm so tired of what I've been doing. Then, one image without form came, and I quit. Look for someone else to tend the shop. I'm out of the image-making business. Finally, I know the freedom of madness. A random image arrives. I scream, "Get out!" It disintegrates. Only love. Only the holder the flag fits into, and wind. No flag. Inside this new love, die. Your way begins on the other side. Become the sky. Take an axe to the prison wall. Escape. Walk out like someone suddenly born into color. Do it now. You are covered with thick cloud. Slide out the side. Die and be quiet. Quietness is the surest sign that you've died. Your old life was a frantic running from silence. The speechless full moon comes out now. Sometimes I forget completely what companionship is. Unconscious and insane, I spill sad energy everywhere. My story gets told in various ways. A romance, a dirty joke, a war, a vacancy. Divide up my forgetfulness to any number, it will go around. dark suggestions that I follow, are they part of some plan? Friends, be careful. Don't come near me out of curiosity or sympathy. Notice how each particle moves. Notice how everyone has just arrived here from a journey. Notice how each wants a different food. Notice how the stars vanish as the sun comes up, and how all streams stream toward the ocean. Look at the chefs preparing special plates for everyone according to what they need. Look at this cup that can hold the ocean. Look at those who see the face. Look through Shams's eyes into the water that is entirely jewels. Again, the violet bows to the lily. Again, the rose is tearing off her gown. The green ones have come from the other world, tipsy, like the breeze up to some new foolishness. Again, near the top of the mountain, the anemone's sweet features appear. The hyacinth speaks formally to the jasmine. Peace be with you, and peace to you, lad. Come walk with me in this meadow. Again, there are Sufis everywhere. The bud is shy, but the wind removes her veil suddenly. My friend! The friend is here, like water in the stream, like a lotus on the water. The narcissist winks at the wisteria, whenever you say. And the clove to the willow, you are the one I hope for. The willow replies, consider these chambers of mine yours. Welcome. The apple, orange, why the frown? So that those who need harm will not see my beauty. The ringdove comes asking, where is the friend? And with one note, the nightingale indicates the rose. Again, the season of spring has come, and the spring source rises under everything, a moon sliding from the shadows. Many things must be left unsaid because it's late, but whatever conversation we haven't had tonight, we'll have tomorrow. The core of masculinity does not derive from being male, nor friendliness from those who console. Your old grandmother says, maybe you shouldn't go to school. You look a little pale. Run when you hear that. A father's stern slaps are better. Your bodily soul wants comforting. The severe father wants spiritual clarity. He scolds, but eventually leads you into the open. Pray for a tough instructor to hear and act and stay within you. We have been busy accumulating solace. Make us afraid of how we were. I honor those who try to rid themselves of any lying, who empty the self and have only clear being there. This place is a dream. Only a sleeper considers it real. Then death comes like dawn, and you wake up laughing at what you thought was your grief. But there is a difference with this dream. Everything cruel and unconscious done in the illusion of the present world, all that does not fade away at the death waking. It stays and it must be interpreted. All the mean laughing, all the quick sexual wanting, those torn coats of Joseph, they change into powerful wolves that you must face. The retaliation that sometimes comes now, the swift payback hit, is just a boy's game to what the other will be. You know about circumcision here, it's full castration there. In this groggy time we live, this is what it's like. A man goes to sleep in the town where he has always lived, and he dreams he's living in another town. In the dream, he doesn't remember the town he's sleeping in his bed in. He believes the reality of the dream town. The world is that kind of sleep. The dust of many crumbled cities settles over us like a forgetful doze, but we are older than those cities. We began as a mineral. We merged into plant life and into the animal state, and then into being human. And always we have forgotten our former states, except in early spring when we slightly recall being green again. That's how a young person turns toward a teacher. That's how a baby leans toward the breast, without knowing the secret of its desire, yet turning instinctively. Humankind is being led along an evolving course through this migration of intelligences. And though we seem to be sleeping, there is an inner wakefulness that directs the dream. And that will eventually startle us back to the truth of who we are. I need a mouth as wide as the sky to say the nature of a true person. Language as large as longing. The fragile vial inside me often breaks. No wonder I go mad and disappear for 3 days every month with the moon. For anyone in love with you, it's always these invisible days. I've lost the thread of the story I was telling. my elephant roams his dream of Hindustan again. Narrative, poetics, destroyed, my body, a dissolving, a return. Friend, I've shrunk to a hair trying to say your story. Would you tell mine? I've made up so many love stories. Now I feel fictional. Tell me. The truth is, you are speaking, not me. I am Sinai, and you are Moses walking there. This poetry is an echo of what you say. A piece of land can't speak or know anything. Or if it can, only within limits. The body is a device to calculate the astronomy of the spirit. Look through that astrolabe and become oceanic. Why this distracted talk? It's not my fault I rave. You did this. Do you approve of my love madness? Say yes. What language will you say it in? Arabic or Persian or what? Once again, I must be tied up. Bring the curly ropes of your hair. Now I remember the story. A true man stares at his old shoes and sheepskin jacket. Every day he goes up to his attic to look at his work shoes and worn-out coat. This is his wisdom, to remember the original clay and not get drunk with ego and arrogance. To visit those shoes and jacket is praise. The absolute works with nothing. The workshop, the materials are what does not exist. Try and be a sheet of paper with nothing on it. Be a spot of ground where nothing is growing, where something might be planted. A seed, possibly, from the absolute. I feel like the ground, astonished at what the atmosphere has brought to it. What I know is growing inside me. Rain makes every molecule pregnant with a mystery. We groan with women in labor. The ground cries out, I am truth, and glory is here. Breaks open, and a camel is born out of it. A branch falls from a tree, and there is a snake. Muhammad said, a faithful believer is a good camel, always looking to its master, who takes perfect care. He brands the flank. He sets out hay. He binds the knees with reasonable rules. And now he loosens all bindings and lets his camel dance, tearing the bridle and ripping the blankets. The field itself sprouts new forms while the camel dances over them. Imaginary plants no one has thought of. But all these new seeds, no matter how they try, do not reveal the other sun. They hide it. Still, the effort is joy, one by one to keep uncovering pearls and oyster shells. This being human is a guest house. Every morning, a new arrival. A joy, a depression, a meanness. Some momentary awareness comes as an unexpected visitor. Welcome and entertain them all, even if they're a crowd of sorrows who violently sweep your house empty of its furniture. Still, treat each guest honorably. He may be clearing you out for some new delight. The dark thought, the shame, the malice. Meet them at the door laughing and invite them in. Be grateful for whoever comes, because each has been sent as a guide from beyond. God has given us a dark wine so potent that, drinking it, we leave the two worlds. God has put into the form of hashish a power to deliver the taster from self-consciousness. God has made sleep so that it erases every thought. God made Majnun love Layla so much that just her dog would cause confusion in him. There are thousands of wines that can take over our minds. Don't think all ecstasies are the same. Jesus was lost in his love for God. His donkey was drunk with barley. Drink from the presence of saints, not from those other jars. Every object, every being is a jar full of delight. Be a connoisseur and taste with caution. Any wine will get you high. Judge like a king and choose the purest, the ones unadulterated with fear or some urgency about what's needed. Drink the wine that moves you as a camel moves when it's been untied and is just ambling about. It's the old rule that drunks have to argue and get into fights. The lover is just as bad. He falls into a hole, but down in that hole, he finds something shining, worth more than any amount of money or power. Last night, the moon came dropping its clothes in the street. I took it as a sign to start singing, falling up into the bowl of sky. The bowl breaks. Everywhere is falling. Everywhere. Nothing else to do. Here is the new rule. Break the wine glass and fall toward the glass blower's breath. This that is tormented and very tired, tortured with restraints like a madman, this heart. Still, you keep breaking the shell to get the